Right, John, the next thing that gets brought up at every meeting and has caused quite a lot of, quite a lot of kind of concern with a lot of members across the country is what happens if we reject this? And our answer to this yesterday and in each of our branch meetings up till yesterday has been...
Consistent? Yeah, really consistent. I think, obviously, the announcement today changes things.
Changes everything.
Significantly. However, it absolutely fits in with what we've been saying consistently. What branches are telling us consistently? When this is rejected, when the membership reject this, Scottish Government have got a decision to make. So, the questions you get asked or things that come up in branch meetings is, do we lose the money?
Yeah.
Well, straight away, why would we lose money? The Scottish Government invested 21 million quid.
Yeah.
Effectively 21 million quid in the hole for this. But we know from the service's own FAQs how much this proposal would cost them a month. £500,000. So 6 million quid a year. 6 million quid a year for the Scottish Government is a comparatively small amount of money, particularly if it's a comparatively small amount of money that can can deliver real change within a firefighter's role and deliver real sort of public good. Orca, not only responding
massive. Absolutely massive.
Not only responding to Orca incidents, and making real progress in that sort of 1 in 10, I think it is now, out of hospital cardiac arrest survivability rate, getting more towards that sort of Scandinavian figure type, rolling out across 356 stations, massive reach, that's a huge part from Scottish Government, where members going out and, delivering CPR, BFIB training, schools, public groups, again, 356 stations, massive reach. That's a huge, huge, we've got a massive role to deliver in the Scottish Government's out of hospital cardiac arrest strategy. So, and we spoke about MTFA, that expanded role in the warm zone, the MTA incident. That has real ability to address some of the concerns that came up in the Kerslake report, the Manchester bombing, and having a really significant role in sort of expanded home fire safety visits, the signposting.
Real quality signposting.
Yep, really good quality signposting of vulnerable people to partner agencies who can themselves make a really positive intervention and prevent people coming from harm, reduce the risk of social exclusion, all these sort of priorities of the Scottish Government, that kind of public good.
And it's always been difficult. It's always looked like the kind of logical progression for this would be the Scottish Government would look at the value we can provide them and not want, and also the record of the last 10 years in industrial relations has been excellent. They've stepped in on so many different occasions, and all the conversations we've had in Parliament with MSPs has always been positive. They've got a really good, they have a real commitment to collective bargaining with the role of trade union. So, but to get that statement, that we have publicly been told that the funding isn't going to drop off when this is rejected, this removes the any reason to vote for this proposal, because it looked like the only reason anybody was voting for this was because they were scared of going out, being dragged into industrial action down south, or that this funding was going to go and we were going to lose the only option of getting a pay rise over the last number of years. That fear has gone. That has been erased.
And I think this is massive for us. It wasn't necessary to be there in the first place, because as you say, Scottish Government, really good track record in industrial relations, really invested in that kind of partnership working between trade unions and employers, see a real value in that. And there is a real value to this to Scottish Government, there's a real value to this to the public, the greater good of the public, and firefighters are absolutely invested in, they absolutely recognise conference policy for five years now has been expansion of OMAP for a reasonable pay increase. That's always been the strategy.
Yep.
And so I think the Scottish Government recognise that. It's no great surprise, but it's excellent confirmation, absolute excellent confirmation to have somebody the stature of the Fire Minister, not the Fire Minister, the stature of the Finance Minister, Derek Mackay, and I think it also shows having a really good organised approach to this kind of stuff.
Mm.
The power of the clout of the STUC.
Excellent to have them working behind this, and can we thank them enough for their involvement here?
Absolutely. And the importance of unions like ourselves and being affiliated to the STUC, and also of our own regional officials, the work they've
fantastic done. Fantastic
work across the ground, across all our areas of area officials, the work our branches have done, our branch reps have done in being organised. Ultimately, the end game for this, or the goal for this, is for a proposal that benefits firefighters, benefits the Scottish Fire and Rescue Service, benefits the Scottish Government, and benefits the public in Scotland. And that's absolutely there to be deliverable. So, there's no cliff edge to drop off. The reassurance from the Finance Minister is important there. I expect reform. Conference policy is for reform.
And we are offering that.
Absolutely.
And we are offering
it's just having it proportionate to role and making sure that it's something that can be safely delivered.
this has been a it's been a very, very heartening morning to see that coming out, to have that kind of backup. It has to be the highlight, and it couldn't have come at a better time the day that the ballot opened.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's important, you know, there was a small number of members had concerns.
And you can understand that.
It's been 3.5 years of this, you know, since the first indication from the chairing board, so around 3.5 years ago, that it was potentially, you know, a better deal to be had in Scotland. Like we say, 4.5 years of conference strategy. It's been going on a long time, you know. Members, you know, have gone worked through that, and I can understand the frustration, but absolutely at a point now, there is a, you know, this is early stages. This is our first proposal from the service. We've identified consistently across all the branches about what the issues are with it. We know the proposal is going to be rejected. It's going to be rejected in high numbers, but absolutely there is a way forward to it.
Clear as